grilling and re-willing.
Garbage for that.
Handle's coming off. Comes off. Nice strip. That one might be too. This one's good. That one's stripped too.
Drop it down and push it down into the cabinet. Yep. Take them up and out all the way.
Stripped.
That one's good.
Salt and pepper. Plug in the holes. Rod?
No, it's a fart knocker.
Fart knocker rods going into the holes with wood glue. The original tight bond wood glue.
Can you go get me a thing of paper towels off the board?
Yep. Plug in the holes, toothpicks and dowel rod.
Clean the piping off with some rubbing alcohol. Clean up nicely.
Air dry the 1960 lead badge off. Big plumper here.
Maybe you do that.
What you do is you put it in and then you turn. Don't like yank it. There's no point in doing that. Just put it in there. You know what I mean? See, I'm using the wood as a fulcrum. I gotta move it down.
I think everybody gets a point here. What's going on?
Yep.
Time to get to work. Grill cloth is off. No more holes.
This all down, some cleaner, put it all in here. Got this all cleaned up.
Salt and pepper.
Okay, help me. Badges are going on.
My fingers are so calloused, I can't feel the hole.
Tap, little tap will do ya.
Look, these are the original screw-ins here. They don't punch.
Gotcha.
They're not supposed to rip down through us. All that bullshit. That's why it's just worth it just to buy the right thing. Because you're sealing the cabinet, essentially. The plastic doesn't rust. And that, when the screws into it, it seals with the plastic. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
With the threads of plastic. Okay, now the reason why I'm doing this is because I want to put the...
Here we go. We're gonna heat the grill up, tighten it up with a hairdryer. Do this for about 20 minutes. We're gonna check back and see how it plays out. Boom. Last little wave over here, and I think we're caught. Nice and taut, tight, no waves.